So I'm gonna just jump in here and do sort of like a really quick update because I probably won't have time to film tomorrow, and today is actually Friday. And I just got a phone call saying that Jay could, they think he's gonna be able to come home. He's got a physical therapy this afternoon, and I'm gonna head down to go see him. And it looks like he might be able to come home today. I'm nervous and I'm excited. I'm nervous because I worry about whether or not I can take good care of him, whether or not he's gonna actually listen to me. You know, he can be a stubborn, you know, old goat. He can be a stubborn guy. But I'm so nervous that something will happen and he'll have another relapse and all that. But at the same time, I'm so excited about having him come home because I haven't been sleeping. I've been tossing and turning all night. I wake up at 2-3 o'clock in the morning and I'm up for the whole day. And it's just like, whoa, you know? And like last night, my son came, oh my gosh. And my son and his friend came and they brought me this candle to relax me, right? And because obviously I had called out and said, can one of you come and change my water filter? I need a water filter changed. And then I kind of said, no, I'm also out of gas. So my son came, did my water filter for me. And then he took my car and he put gas in it. So I have a full tank of gas. I'm excited about that. I would have done it. I would have pumped the gas on my own. I know I would have. I've never pumped gas in this car. It's a fairly new car. I've only had it like 3 years now. I think 3 years in February. I know this sounds awful. I've never pumped gas in it. Well, Jay has always pumped my gas for me. So, but I know I would have been able to figure it out. It's just it's so much nicer that Michael was able to do that. Michael and his friend, and they brought me that candle. It's so, it smells so, so nice. I love it. You know, lavender and relaxes you. So, I've got a load of laundry in. I'm going to try to figure out. I'm going to move the table against the wall and stuff like that, and just try to prepare the house a little bit for, you know, for him to come in, because I think when I go down to Salem, I'm going to be picking him up. He's still going to have to do rehab, but outpatient. And there's a rehabilitation center that's affiliated with Northeast Rehab where he's been, right here next town over. So I'm like, okay, that'll be a piece of cake for me to, you know, to get him there and all that. So I'm excited, I'm nervous. And I know I probably won't have time to do a video, or if I do a real video, it won't be till Sunday, but I wanted to update everyone. And I had, you know, a couple of things, like I wanted to talk about my hair. I've been using the Current Body hair hat, you know, the hair hat helmet. I've been using that. And, you know, just a couple of other, I got another bathing suit that came in, and I almost got scammed again by another company. I can't believe these scammers are out there. You know, I had bought the bathing suit. I talked about it in my last video. I talked about how much I was really loving these bathing suits and how I was thrilled with the quality of the product. And I posted it on YouTube. I posted it on Instagram. Well, later that day, I got an email from the same Cup She, right? Is the company saying that, I forgot how they said it, but anyway, something about appreciating my, you know, having talked about their product, and would I be interested in reviewing some of their products, and what would my fee structure be, you know? And I'm like going, geez, you know, nobody ever pays me. I'm too small for anyone, but I was like, wow. And I got the email when I was in the hospital with Jay, and I said, Jay, look at this. This is the company I ordered the bathing suits from. Can you believe it? They're reaching out to me. I was like so excited. He's going, wow. And so he said, what are you gonna tell him? So I reached out to a few of my online friends in a chat group. And I said, you know, what are the fee structures? So we chatted back and forth. So I sent an email with a general fee structure. And they said, okay, we'll send you a box of clothing a month. You can pick your style, pick your size, and we'll pay you, I forgot what they, I think it was like $75 to post it on Instagram. But I'm thinking, you know, what the heck, right? So you can go look here. And I'm like going, and then, so when I looked, and the first thing I noticed when I went and looked on the website was it had a different name on top. So I said, oh, but they had really nice clothes, but it had a different name on top. So I went back into the email and I said, the website link you sent me to did not bring me to a cup she website brought me to a living something else. And next thing I know is I get an email that says, yes, that's right, pick your products. This is a new launch. This is, you know, really sounded legitimate. So I didn't really answer it because, you know, I was busy. I was running around and all that stuff. I figured I'd wait till the weekend. And then I got another email saying that I have to set up my PayPal account because they have hundreds of thousands of influencers reviewing their products and that they could not afford to send products without charging for shipping. So please set up your PayPal, arrange for the shipping, and we'll send you the product. Well, as soon as I saw that, hundreds of thousands of influencers, and they could not afford to pay for the shipping, my antenna went up, and I went back to the email, and I looked at it. It was cupshe001@gmail.com. So I went on to Instagram to the page for cupshe, where I bought the bathing suits, and I sent them a message. Well, disappointingly enough, they haven't bothered to answer me. But I know that's the legitimate site, and they probably aren't. I'm probably in their other email box. They're probably not paying attention to social media or things. And, you know, my question was simply, is this really you, or am I being spammed? But they did not bother to answer me, and I was bummed about that. But I did determine it was a spam, so I was really glad I never went forward with it. But that just goes to show you how crazy these people are that spam people. You know, I mean, they find all of these different things to spam people about. It's like totally, totally insane. So I was bummed, but hey, so be it. But like I was saying in that other video, I ordered another bathing suit. Why am I going on bathing suits? Well, I'll have to tell you that some other time. I'm not going to really, I keep looking over here instead of over here. Sorry, I'm on my phone. I'll have to tell you that some other time. But anyway, so I did order another bathing suit and it came in. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. I'll show it to you in another video. And I'm going to show you a demo of those compression bags that I bought, the bags to really pack your clothes really small. I have a friend, Ramona, who did, I think I mentioned, she did 2 weeks in Ireland and London and Paris on a carry-on. I'm like, there's absolutely no way Jay and I could ever do a carry-on. But if we could just travel with one bag, that would be, you know, even if we have to check it, that would be cool. So I got these compression bags. So I want to see how they work and talk about that. And I mean, there's a bunch of stuff I want to talk about, but I just don't have any time. So you're going to be getting this kind of rambling little video update where I'm looking here instead of here. But I'm so excited because I'm going to have my husband back home and I don't want to be a wimp because I know I'm lucky that I have a husband to come back home to come, you know, to bring back home. And I know some people don't and all that. So I don't want to be like a pity party or whatever, but it's been difficult and it's been, you know, a challenge. He's been gone for over a week. It's been almost 2 weeks. Oh my God, I'm losing track. He's been gone for almost 2 weeks. Wow. And so in between my regular real estate job, you know, my training and all that, which I'm thankfully only working part-time. Can you imagine if I was still pulling my 40 hours, my full-time job? I'm only doing that part-time, but I have two sales. I have other real estate stuff that I'm doing that is super time-consuming. And then I had to create a video. I don't know if you guys know about ChatGPT, but artificial intelligence. So I had to do a training video on ChatGPT because I'm doing a workshop on it. So I had to get that done. But anyways, I'm just standing here gibber jabbering to you guys, and it's probably already almost 10 minutes, and talking about nothing except that I'm excited that my husband is going to be coming home. I'm going to be leaving here shortly. I'm going to go to I'm gonna go to the grocery store, pick up some stuff, and then pick up my husband, and I'm gonna have to try to figure out how I'm gonna, I almost said baby proof. I don't mean baby proof. I certainly don't mean baby proof, but I'm gonna have to try to handicap proof it. I don't know. The table is still pushed over and stuff, but anyways, I just wanted to give you guys an update. I will get to all the comments in the other video. I haven't read some of them. I haven't read all of them yet, but I will definitely get to you guys. And filming this on Friday, I may upload this Friday night or early Saturday morning, but your prayers, everything, you know, I know many of you've reached out separately and you've all been praying for Jay, and I'm like, so psyched. Thank you guys so much. And yeah, things might get back to normal. Yeah.